Hey foodies, welcome back to our channel guys. You're watching Get Set and Cook with Pratima and Chandana. So today's recipe is continuation of our Save These Sad Little Bananas part 2. So for part 1, we have made banana French toast, which I'm going to leave a link right above. For part 2, let's get started. So I know everybody is tired of hearing about banana bread, but this is the most healthiest version of banana bread that you'll come across. So let's check out what we'll need. I've taken about 14 tablespoons of oats here, about 12 to 15 dates, 1/4 cup of walnuts, I love walnuts guys, 1/4 cup of badam, some milk, 1/4 cup of pistachios, 1 egg and about 3 medium sized overripe bananas. Let's get started. Now I'm going to mash all these bananas until they form liquid consistency. As you can see here, I've not added any ingredients that would normally go into making a regular cake. So you can enjoy this guilt free. You want the bananas to be in this consistency. Now I've taken about 14 tablespoons of oats here, which I'm going to grind into a nice powder. This cake has no oil, no maida, no butter, no sugar or anything that would actually make it fattening. It's not the best in taste, but it's really healthy and it actually tastes pretty good too. Now let's get into processing the nuts and stuff we've taken. I'm going to take badam and crush it. It's easier to crush it instead of cutting the badam, so you can see you're going to get a similar result itself. Also chop your dates finely and set them aside. I prefer cutting my pistachios instead of crushing them. Cut them into fine bits like this and then set them aside. I've taken some dates, some walnuts, crushed badam, chopped pistachios, and I'm going to add all these into a bowl and mix them up nicely. So one pro tip that you want to know here is whenever you're adding anything into your cake batter, coat them with your dry ingredients. Over here it's the oat flour that we have taken. If you coat your ingredients with some of the dry ingredients, they won't sink when you bake them. Otherwise, all your additions into the batter tend to sink. So keep that in mind. Now to the bananas, I'm adding in 1 egg and I'm going to nicely beat it. You don't need a blender here, just a whisk is enough. Just whisk it for like a minute or a minute and a half. That should do. This recipe was requested a lot from a lot of my friends. So to all of you who are, you know, wanting to enjoy cake guilt-free, this recipe is for you. Now I added in oats and I'm adding in about 1 teaspoon of baking powder and I'm giving it a good mix. All the sweetness that you'll need will be derived from the bananas and the dates itself. Of course, this cake will be a little less on the sweet side, but it's very healthy, so please do try it. I'm not going to make this in an oven or a pressure cooker. I'm just going to keep it in a kadai and show you guys how to do it. So let's see, okay. Now I'm adding in about 1 tablespoon of milk and giving it a good mix. You want the consistency to be something like this. To now grease a bread tin and add in your mixture. Look at the consistency, it should be something like this itself. If it's too liquidy, the cake won't be good. Look here guys, I've taken a kadai to which I've added some salt and put in a stand as a support to our cake mold. I've already preheated this for about 10 minutes on high heat and I'm going to bake this cake for about 40 to 45 minutes on low heat. You don't need an oven or a pressure cooker to do this, just this is enough. Once it's done, insert a toothpick and check. If the toothpick comes out clean, then your cake is done. Let it cool and then enjoy this guilt-free. This is a very nice recipe, so please do try it out. Please subscribe to my channel and thank you so much for watching.